Are we on? Oh, okay, well then. Hello, everyone, around this big, beautiful blue marble we call Earth and wherever universe we may live in. I am Robert D. Nickel. Normally, we would start the show of SEA Revengeance 2021, but the problem is, looks like Nereza Malatesta is hijacking the show. Uh-oh. And she's demanding for a mic. This is not going to be good. This is the end of the new girl. Damn, she's really that hot-headed. Instead of just waiting for a chance to actually make her pay-per-view debut, she wants a fight. She wants a match here at Revengeance. I give her props for her tenacity, but she has to realize that sometimes you may not be able to make it to the pay-per-view, and sometimes you will. And besides, she's still a rookie. So she's hijacking the show. Oh, Nikes. Damn. All righty then. Can we get Nickel Jam down to the ring? Cause we're gonna kick off SEA Revengeance off with a bang. All right, Nickel Chan's in the ring. I guess this is happening. Well, as the saying goes, cards subject to change. And this is our opening contest here at SEA Revengeance 2021. Osako in an impromptu match against the newcomer, Nereza Malatesta. Nereza actually hijacked the show earlier, just a little while ago, demanding she wanted to be on the card. And she asked either the Jinx Trixie Decker, who's going to be in an SEA Tag Team title match later on tonight, so she wanted Osako. Well, ask and ye shall receive. And so far, she's already getting a little strong head start over against the legend. Oh, what a spin kick there by Osako. Oh, a double axe of them on Nereza. And now a knee jam. Trying to go for those spin kicks. Ooh, miss on the clothesline. Ducks under. Ooh, nice speed there by, and into the drop toe hold. And a spinning back kick. Or should I say a spin kick to the back? Throws Naraza under the ropes. Nice suplex there by Oseko. And Oseko now off the ropes into a knee drop. Knee drop. Naraza now with the scoop slam. Oseko hit Naraza on the head. She has to learn patience. Sure, she's a rookie and she wants to be able to showcase her talents, but she's got to be wary of her chances. She's not going to be able to make it to every pay-per-view, either by booking decisions or by injuries. And now she might be able to pull out the biggest win of her career and skyrocket her stardom, but I doubt it because Oseko knows how to take a fight. Being a master ninja and all. Oh, nice. Now under the crab from Naraza. Nice takedown there by Oseko. Don't forget, Oseko has a match later on tonight as she takes on Mao Ran of Yami no Kamishu. Nice shooting star person in the cover. Just not even a one count. Late, this is SEA Revenge. We got a stacked card here tonight. Not only Oseko's got Mao Ran later on tonight, we got almost every championship on the line. Queen of Hardcore's championship in a last woman standing match. Riot of Betsy chair shot in what it is, Betsy's last chance at the Hardcore title. If she can't get it this time, she ain't getting it again. We got the tag team titles on the line as the Dynasties, Dynasty Envy and Trixie Decker defend against the loss in Ogami Kongo. Then the winners of the first ever Queens of Fighters tournament finally get their respective championship matches. Riku wants the Rosa Roses championship. She's going after Elena Miyazawa. Yuna will go after Nasha Han for the Women's Championship. And of course, Shadow Dar will defend the Queen of Roses championship against the woman who never lost the title in the first place, Pain. And also in a grudge match, KO wants revenge on Roxy Wright for what happened in the tournament. Actually, let me fix that. Roxy wants revenge on KO after what happened in the Queen of Fighters tournament when she got knocked out, leaving almost drowned in a pool of her own blood during the match. But anyway, let's get back to this contest right here. Beautiful arm ball reversal there by Oseko, but she was on the ropes. Oh, look at this pinning predicament. Small, modified small package, just a one count. Cover now by just a one count by Naraza. Oof. Oh, nice combinations and discus there by Naraza. Naraza now off the ropes into a big boot. Another big boot there by Naraza under the back. Naraza trying to prove that she can hang with the big guns and she can hang with the forefront. That just proves that she's ready to go into the mainstay here in SEA. Look at this modified regal stretch here. Pulling on the hair. Pulling on the neck, really putting the torque in. But Oseko's been through that move before. Oh, what a suplex there by Oseko. Could that be a spinning Uranagi? Nice shooting the half. Now the ground and pound. The hammer strikes by Naraza. Let's see if we get out of that one. And Naraza throws Oseko to the outside. Best believe Mao Ran is watching this backstage with a huge smile on her face, knowing that she might not have a full healthy Oseko at the when their match comes down later on the night. But knowing Oseko, she'll go in strides, just going for a couple matches. Naraza now from the top rope into a fish drop onto the back. Going at it again, two times, and one just standing for good measure. Oh, butterfly DDT. Oh, into the crucifix. Two? No. And now throws Nerez to the outside. Nice, nice roundhouse kicks by Dos Equis. Throw there by Dos Equis. And we can regain some of that energy. Went for the wheel kick but missed. Beautiful, beautiful suplex there by Dos Equis. Oh, into the sleeper hold. And a penalty kick on the chest. And a standing shooting star. Not even a cover because she was in the ropes. Nego now. Pop up Hurricane Rana with the roll up. Just a one count. Nice wheel kick there by Dos Equis. Dos Equis now from the top rope. Into a shooting star under the back. Twice now. A sleeper hold and penalty kick combination. Nice judo throw. Another standing shooting star. Cover now. One. Just not even a two count. Cover now by Malatesta. Two. No. Barely. For a spin kick there. Now look at this submission hold right here. And Nerez taps. Man, what an impromptu opening contest we have here for SEA Revengeance. Good God Almighty, this show is going to be nothing but insane, nothing but crazy. We'll be right back. And we are back with SEA Revengeance 2021. Man, what an opening contest we just had here earlier tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Nerez wanted her spot in the show. Well, she got it already, but she fell to the forefront Dos Equis, who now has to go back and regroup very fast, because still later on tonight she's got to take on Malron. We get set up for our second contest here tonight at Revengeance. It's a grudge match, ladies and gentlemen, as Roxy Ride wants to get revenge on KO after what happened in the Queen of Fighters tournament. Remember, in her matchup with KO, she got knocked out by her, but unfortunately she was also bleeding, so she almost nearly drowned in her own blood. Ooh, that's not good. So she wants revenge on the woman who almost literally cost her life. Here comes the woman that caused all the trouble, KO. This is going to be one hell of a fist fight. Here we go. Nice uppercut there by KO. Now an arm wrench by arm wrench into the arm bar from Roxy. There's Roxy into the corner. Ooh, nice axe kick there by KO there. Nice Ease arm drag there by Roxy. Went for the jumping enziguri, but missed. Now another arm wrench. Drops it down into the arm bar. KO gets out of that one. Nice forearm there. Nice elbow there by him. Roxy, both went different moves, but neither one gets him. Nice reversal there by KO. And throws Roxy into the ropes. Oh, nice judo throw there by Roxy. Another Japanese arm drag there by Roxy again. Nice slam there by Roxy. Ooh, into a headbutt downstairs. Nice combination there. Ooh, but went for the dropkick, but KO takes her at the knees. There's KO in the ropes. Nope. Ooh, nice reversal by Roxy. He throws KO into the corner. KO again with those combinations.
Over.
And now she's throwing in chops, but Roxy's taking it in strides. But she took that right one to the right one. Oh, nice reversal into the roll up. Not even a one count. Nice blocking there by KO on both those drop kicks. Nice uppercut.
Over.
And a chop by Roxy. Roxy now again from another full fireman's carry face drop, front slam, I should say. I'm sorry. Now she gives a KO chop. And now KO, nice reversal by Roxy into the suplex. And takes her down the knees. Uh-oh, no way. Oh my God, she got knocked out again. KO has knocked out Roxy this fast. Oh good God, that's not gonna be good when Roxy wakes up. We'll be right back. Oh good God. All right, we're back with more Revengeance. Man, that had to be humiliating for Roxy. She wanted revenge on KO, but instead she got knocked out again. But thankfully she wasn't cut, so I think she's just gonna be when she wakes up later on after tonight, she's gonna be like, whatever, like, oh, you kidding me? Oh, well. All right, let's get back into the action here tonight here on Revengeance. Oh boy, this one's gonna be an ugly one. It's time for our first of five championship matches, and it's for the Queen of Hardcore Championship. Riott defends against Betsy Chairshot in a last woman standing match. Remember, this is Betsy's last chance at the Queen of Hardcore Championship. She has to make the most of it. Man, and how determined Betsy is, this might be her life is on the line. But this is important, as Riott stated. If Betsy does not capture the Queen of Hardcore Championship here tonight, she can never challenge for that championship so long as Riott is still holding that belt. and it's not going to be an easy one. It's last woman standing. No pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, no DQs. The only way to win is to incapacitate or take your opponent so much so they can't get up to the referee's 10 counts. Oh boy. You want violence? Well, here's your violence. And here comes the chairwoman. Can Betsy Chairshot prove that she's no backyard wrestling hack and take the hardcore title from Riott? This is her third and last chance, and she did not capture the title. Well, she ain't getting any more chances. And here we go. Oof, nice elbow there by Riott.
Come on.
Oof, and Riott goes downstairs, but it's all legal. Remember, it's last woman standing. You can beat each other senseless, but if you can get your opponent stay down for 10 seconds, you win. No pinfalls there, Betsy. Sorry. Let's go downstairs. Nice drop to hold there by Riott. Again with another forearm by Riott.
Come on.
Betsy was in the corner, got out of it. Another fireman's carry slam. Throws right. Went for the spin kick, but Riott blocked. Shoots the half, throws right into the corner. Riott gets out of it. Excuse me. Now both ladies are throwing bombs. Nice shot there. Drop to a hole by Betsy. Ooh, again downstairs goes Riott. And an elbow.
Doesn't get that.
Oh, we got a chair. Scoop slam onto the chair. Remember, it's all legal. Oof, another time goes downstairs. Roxy again with the drop toe hold. Another nice Japanese arm drag there by Betsy. And a knee to the gut. Nice arm wrench. Right now. Throws Betsy in. Betsy gets out of it quick. Oof, nice open palm strike there by Riott. Betsy into the young ropes. Drops under. I don't know what she had planned, but... Betsy now. Shoots the half. Into the German suplex. And Riott throws Betsy to the outside. Like no count outs against the player. She can be there as much as she wants. Oh, but I don't think it's. No, she did. Right now with the arm wrench. And back to the hammer lock.
Oh!
Nice left hand there by Wright, and downstairs again. Another scoop slam with the chair. Betsy now, come again on. With the front slam. Right. Pop up powerbomb. She has a pop up sit out powerbomb. Another drop to a hold by Betsy. Now into a knee bar. Riot with the crab. Oh, and throws a fork in her face. Oh, package. Pile driver! Is she out? Let's see.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Betsy gets up at the count of 8.
Come on.
Wait a minute. What the hell just happened? And now Roxy now. Now Riot takes on Betsy, puts Betsy in, it'll scrape it over the fork. Oh, what a beal. Nice drop kick there by Riot. Betsy now. Oh, nice snapmare. Ooh, a backbreaker by Riot. And now just jamming the fork right back into Betsy's head. And Betsy's busted open. Oh, power bomb by Wright, and Nicholson minimizes the count.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Was that 9 before Betsy got up? And now both women are doing a slap fight. Nice chop there by Betsy. Nice right there by Riot. And a drop kicks into there. Betsy now with a snap suplex. Nice combination there by Betsy. Throws right into the ropes. He gets nothing for it. Right now, off the ropes, into a double axe handle on the back. Nice takedown by Betsy into the armbar. Now to a sleeper hold. Record. Nope. Into the German suplex. Now in a cross face.
Come on.
Kicks there by Riot. Oh, another crucifix bomb by Riot, by Roxy, gets right back up and gets an elbow, and eats an elbow. Right now, off the ropes, into the double axe handle.
6, 7.
Just a 7 count on that one. And throws Riot to the outside. Betsy now. Betsy gonna fly. Oh, rope touch, suing star press. And she's got out a guardrail. Well, why not? It's no disqualification, so go for it. Another crossface on the floor.
Dip and
Oh no. Oh god! And throws rocks right under the guardrail on the outside. And a crossbody on it. Two's a half. Ripcord. Oh, and throws into the apron. And now jams a chair in Riot's throat. Uh-oh. Are we thinking jackknife? Yes, we are. Jackknife on the freaking guardrail. Oh, what an axe kick by Betsy. And another drop toe hold. Betsy gets back in the ring. Now another crossface. Oh, we're gonna get another jackknife. Yes, we are. Jackknife power bomb by Riot, but Betsy gets right back up into the armbar. Oh, nice head scissor there by Riot. Again with the armbar. And another reversal by Riot. Right now, one more time. Jack knife power bomb. And now the trading blows yet again. Nice headbutt there by Ryan. This could be it. No. Betsy gets right up just before the 10 count. Caught on that one. Oh, into the dragon whip. And now Riot's down.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
She stays in it. Went for the bulldog by Riot. Pushed her off. Now to the arm wrench. Throws Betsy into the corner. Oh, nice reversal, but Riot reverses that one. Riot now from the top rope. Corkscrew moonsault. Riot now throws Betsy to the other corner. Outside of the ring. Scoop slammer.
I think she's
out. Is she out?
Eight,
no.
Nine.
Package pile driver again. That has to be it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
No, she's not. She's a fighter. Again with the crossface. Riot throws Betsy to the outside. Riot now off the ropes. Heads up. Oh, suicide dive. Now just hammering away. And she's got a baseball bat. But she says goes for the chair and wraps it around Betsy's head. Now she's got a light tube. And hits her in the back. Now the bat again. We ain't in the Tokyo Dome. We ain't in the Nippon Stadium. Oh, no, 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 no. Tombstone on the bat! And now Riot's got another leg two. Tries to wrap it around her. Tries to hit her in the head, but didn't. But falls right on it. Betsy now from the top rope with the leg drop. I think this might be it. We might be looking at a new hardcore champion. Betsy's done it! Betsy's done it! She's finally captured the Queen of Hardcore Championship! Third time was lucky! Third time was lucky! We got a new champion! We'll be right back! Welcome back to Revengeance, and if you're just joining us, man, you missed a lot of great matches so far here tonight at Revengeance. We got a brand new Queen of Hardcore Champion. Betsy Chastard finally gets the big win as she knocked out the former champion Riot in a last woman standing match. Once again, KO knocks out Roxy Riot in their match. And we had an impromptu opening contest as Oseiko went one-on-one with up-and-coming Nereza Malatesta as she tried to take the show hostage after not being booked for said contest. But now it is time for our tag team title match. And there is the loss. Lost one half of the challengers here tonight as her and hold on. As her and Ogami Kongo challenge the Dynasty for the tag team titles. Can the loss in Ogami Kongo take away the tag team titles, or will the Dynasty continue their reign as tag team champions? And there's Ogami. These are your challengers for the tag team championship. Here comes the champions. Here's one half of them, the Jinx, Trixie Decker, who later tonight, after this, coming up soon, will be in the semifinals of this year's CCL March Madness tournament. But it's going to be a tough quarter in Glendale. But that's not here or there. Tonight she's got a tag team title defense. As she and here comes her partner, the owner of SCA Envy. Together they are known forever on as the Dynasty. They are the current reigning and defending SEA World Tag Team Champions. And they've been rocking and rolling ever since winning those titles. Correct me if I'm wrong, Chad, but this might be their fourth title defense as tag team champions. Let's see if they can keep their reign going. And it looks like it's going to be Envy and Ogami Kongo starting off this tag team title defense. As you can see, we haven't cleaned up the ring fully from the last woman standing match. So,
come on. So
if you see any new blood stains, sorry. Nice throw there by Ogami. Oh, it ducks the black mist. Nice front suplex slam by Ogami, but gets a bitch slap by Envy and a left.
Come on!
Now test of strength and a forearm by Envy. Now here comes the lost. Nice scoop slam there by Ogami, and a spinning toe hold. Nice takedown there by Envy. Lost now. Went for a suplex, but didn't get it. Oof, nice combination there. But shoots on, but Envy shoots under. Oh, a poke to the eye and a headbutt. And an elbow to the back of the head. Envy now throws what got me, on the loss into the ropes. And he's going to make a tag. Here comes Trixie. Ooh, back elbow by the loss. And once more, this time to the back of the head. Ooh, a double axe handle to the shoulder blades by Trixie.
Yeah.
Nice scoop slam. And a claw to the abdomen. But Trixie gets out of it. This is our second of five title matches. Oh, Trixie got a mic. Oh, right to the face. I thought the rebound hit her. No, it didn't. Here comes Ogami. And here comes Envy. Went for a pump handle on the loss. Here now Ogami and Envy now. And they're trading blows. What a slurry of strikes from both women. Both women are down. Oof. Nice thumb to the eye by Envy. But Okami gets her offer. Here comes the loss. Oh, nice elbow there by the loss. And now loss is choking on Envy, but she gets out of it. Here comes Trixie. And takes both of them down. And now the loss is choking Trixie.
Yeah.
Oof, what a right hand. But Trixie answers with a forearm of her own. Both women are dropping bombs. Who's gonna fall first? And it's the loss and followed by Trixie. Lost now with the cover. Not even a one count. Beautiful side slam by the loss. And here comes Ogami. I mean Kongo. And let's go with that. Trixie now. Nice slap to Kongo. Kongo now with the forearms. Here comes Envy. Ooh, nice elbow there by Envy. And drops on and takes the lead. Oh, double team. Assisted power bomb by Kongo in the loss. And Kongo with the headbutt. And loss with the height with the boot. Nice elbow there by Envy. And again, the loss thumbs the eyes. Oh, what a shot there by Envy. And it takes out the knees. Envy throws the loss in the arm ropes. Envy now, dragging loss to her corner. Got a chair, scoop slam onto the chair. And here comes Trixie. Kongo's in now. Oof. Side headlock. Oh, nice reversal. Into the full Nelson by Trixie. Got her on the front suplex, on the front suplex slam. And a jawbreaker by Trixie. Oh, look at a submission hold. Modified abdominal. But Lost breaks that up. And gives her a headbutt to the back of the head. And a big boot. And throws the Lost into the corner. Now goes up to Kongo. Kongo now. What she got in mind? Power bomb! And folds her up. But Envy breaks that up. Wait. It doesn't matter. She's knocked down. We got new tag team champions. The Lost and Kongo take the titles on the Dynasty. Holy smokes. We got two new champions here tonight. We'll be right back with more action. Holy shmikes and mortals. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Revengeance. Good God almighty, we've got what an amazing show we've had so far tonight. We've got two new champions here tonight, as we have new tag team champions in The Lost and Nogami Kongo, and we got a new Queen of Hardcore champion as in Betsy Chairshot. Now we move on to our next contest here tonight at Revengeance. Oh boy, this one's going to be interesting. It's Malron versus Oseiko. The question is, what is the condition of Oseiko? She just had to go through our opening contest here earlier tonight against Nereza Malatesta as an impromptu match nonetheless. But now she's got to focus on her main target, which is Malron. Malron's in the ring. Let's hear it. Let's listen. But it's not going to be an easy fight with a healthy Malron, but I am. Here we go. Already trying to go for the clothesline. But Oseiko's showing that experience into the drop hold. Nice Kimura lock there by Malron. Now for the hammerlock. Look at the back elbow for a trouble. Ooh, missed on the high kick again. Single throws the block of the corner, but Bond gets out of it. And now they get the knee to the gut. Again with a miss on the kick. Oseiko now. Hanging out. Boards under. Nice take down by Oseiko. Now with the way up. Modified Dragon Sleeper. He gets a high kick of her own. And another knee to the gut. Oseiko still got a lot of energy in that tank of hers. Into the Dragon Screw. Nice take down there by him. Into a modified stump roll. Now to the hammerlock throws Malron. From the high throws, the single little ropes. Into a judo throw. In a stomp. Now both women are just exchanging blows. It's just been strikes all night long between these two. Neither one of them won't go down. But Oseiko does, and so does Ron. Nice axe kick there by Oseiko. Oseiko now. Oh, that same submission. She did that move to Nereza earlier tonight. From Lamar wants two more experience to get that. Oh, what a double kick there by Malone. Filling up that athleticism. Now to another Kimura lock. But Osego gets out of it. Nice wheel kick. Take down there by Malron. Nice roll there by Malron with just a two. No.
One, two.
Now Malron, what she got in mind? Another pinning predicament. Cover now. Two. Not just a two count. Nice monkey flip there by Osako.
Yeah.
And now to the modified ankle lock.
Yeah.
Almost wishbone style. Mal now. Oh, into a knee drive, to a knee drop, to a knee. Went for the clothesline, but didn't get it. Throws Osako back at the ropes, and another knee to the gut. Nice arm drag there by Osako. Cover now.
One.
Nice takedown there, but nice judo throw there by Osako. Oh, into a hurricane runner with the roll up. Just a one count.
One.
Now, nice cut, nice arm bar there by Osako.
Give up.
Nice spin kick there by Malron. Oof, nice combination there. Oh, good God almighty, what a kick. Osako trying to throw in rights, but Malron smart enough to put the hands up and gives her a roundhouse kick to the head. Uh-oh, one more time. Ah! That wicked kick. And takes down Osako. With the strikes, but Ron's putting her hands up and gives her a roundhouse kick for her troubles. Oh, nice reversal by Malron. Cover. Two. Just a two count. Well, both women are trying to go for the same thing, but nobody getting nothing. Oh, she's got it now. She's got her strikes in. Second now from the apron. Gonna fly! She was thinking Hurricane Rana, but Malron was prepared for it. Malron off the ropes. Oh, what a front flip DDT by Malron. Oh, Osako butterfly. No. Nice reversal by Ron. Ron now off the ropes. And a wicked clothesline. And again, both women again are trading strikes. And they're blocking it. Oh, what a sidekick there by Malron. Not even if you thought it was a K&S, you're off. She went right to the gut. Oh, nice shot there by Osako into the judo throw. Osako with the snapmare into the penalty kick.
Yeah.
And now to a sleeper hold.
Give up. Yeah.
another front flip DDT by Mal Ryan. The Seiko. Oh, the GTG Memorial Sling Blade move of God. Nice move there by El Seiko. Another, it looks like another JTG Memorial Sling Blade move of God. Oh, Osaka Street Cutter. And now to the crossface.
Give up.
Seiko trying to slow some strikes in there, but Ron's got her hands up. Oof, and gets a roundhouse again. Ron now, another front flip DDT. But I'll say Seiko was prepared for it. Powerbomb, and folds her over. With the bridge, two. Yes! Seiko takes down Mal Ron. Two matches in one night and two victories for the forefront. We'll be right back with our final three title matches here at Revengeance. And we are back with more Revengeance, and we are now getting set for our final three matches of the night, and all three of them are title matches, and all three of them have importance because they are the three title matches for the winners of the first ever Queens of Fighters tournament. And that, you know, that honor goes to the Gold Wings. All three of them have decided their championships, who they want and where they, who they want and who they want. Payne wants the Queen of Roses championship, the title she never lost. Riku wants the Rose of Roses championship, and Yuna wants the women's title. And we're starting off with the Rose of Roses championship. Riku goes up against Elena Miyazawa, who's been on a hot streak just like her, but more of a what's the word I'm looking for? Vicious way. As if anytime she ever gets a chance for the chance to take someone out, she does with gusto. Now we await the champion. Here comes the Rose of Roses champion, Elena Miyazawa. This is going to be a clash of styles, ladies and gentlemen. Riku's speed and agility versus Miyazawa's tough strength and strikes. Here we go. Nice takedown there by Riku. Another one. Riku now pump handle? No. Oh, and Elena raking the eyes. I guess thrown to the corner by Riku. Nice back elbow by Riku and a foot stomp. Or should I say a double foot stomp? Another pump handle? Nope. Riku with the forearm. So far it's been two for two for new champions here tonight. Can the train continue with this nice senton there by Riku? Or will Elena break that curse and give a win for the defenders? Nice counter there by Riku into the unbox. To the grapevine. Nice judo throw, but Riku counters that as well. And now foot wash by Riku. Ooh, nice back kick by Riku. Into an elbow on the feet. That's the strength there. Riku now on the top rope with the splash from the heavens. But just a one, but not even a count. She was in the ropes. Throws Lena into the corner, but Lena gets out of it. Riku now with the roll up, but she's in the ropes again. Riku now. Oh, looks like almost a power slam there, but and a splash. Cover. Two. No, just a two count. Misses on the strike. Riku now throws her in the corner. Puts her on top. What she got in mind? Oh, double stomp right to the back of the head. And again with the splash, but again she's in the ropes. Nice takedown there by Elena. Uh-oh, vertebraker! Got it! Riku now from the top rope again with the splash from the heavens, but she didn't get full of it. Nice nice job to hold there by Elena. Elena with the throw and Riku tumbles to the outside. Throws Riku to the ropes. Elena ducks under and a vicious left hand. Riku gets out of that one. Caught. Oh, dragon screw by Riku. Elena. Riku went for the Amitsugiri, but didn't get it. Reversal. Tombstone by Riku. Again from the top rope. Again with the splash, but didn't get all of it. Nice shoots to half by, shooting to half by Elena. Now grounding and pounding. Riku now, nice reversal by Elena. Into a takedown. And now to the armbar. She's in the ropes, but I don't think... No, she got out of it. She got out of it. Throws Riku to the ropes. Into the corner. Elena now. Comes at her. Oh, missed. But she gets in the corner as well. And Riku's ready for it. She puts her on top. One more time with the double stomp. Ow! Right on the back of the head. And now Riku now from the top rope. With the splash. This time it connects. Cover. Two. She got it! We got a new Rose of Roses champion! That Riku makes it what? Takes the Rose of Roses championship from Elena Miyazawa! That's one down for the Gold Wings! Two more to go! Our co-main event is coming up next! Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our co-main event of the evening. As I stated before, the Gold Wings have won all the winners of the Queens of Fighters tournament. We've already seen one of them take a championship. Riku has won the Riku with the Rose of Roses championship. Now let's see what's next for the Gold Wings. And it's Yuna. It is going to be Yuna. She's challenging the Women's Championship against Nastasia Han. Let's see if she can make it two for two for the Gold Wings. Here comes the SEA Women's Champion, All right, here she is. There's Nastasia Han, the women's champion. So far tonight, we've had 3 title matches, and they've all ended with new champions. Let's see if we can. Let's see if it's going to be 4 for 4, or will Nastasia Han break the streak and make it and finally give the retain. Yuna the challenger, Han the champion, Neko-chan the referee, and here we go. This is your co-main event.
Fight.
Nice back suplex there by Yuna. Nice knee there by Han. Oh, right under the knee bar there by Yuna, but Han gets out of it. Nice snap there by Han. Nice takedown by Yuna. And now Han with the forearm. Yuna's ready for it. Oh, with the Falcon Arrow. It's not a full deal. Oh, nice sliding elbow by Yuna. And a fireman's carry takedown by Han. Ooh, nice draw to hold by Yuna. Into an elbow drop. Now we gotta test the strength here. Yuna now went for a power bomb, but didn't get it, but Han gives her with a Han gives her a back body drop.
Break. Give up.
Excuse me. Now both Han and Yuna are trading strikes. Who's going to take the most of it? And it's Han. Now Han, deadlift with the gut wrench, suplex. Ooh, now to an abdominal stretch. But Han reverses that one. Now to the crab.
Yeah, you go up.
Really got that wrenched in, but Yuna gets out of it. Nice throw there by Yuna. Yuna now with an arm bar, with a stretched arm bar, and just rubbing the arm on, with an Indian rub on him, on the champion. Throws Yuna into the ropes. Yuna now with a back elbow. Now for the top rope. With the suit, with the moonsault. Oh, nice gut wrench German deadlift, gut wrench German from a deadlift German from our unit. And now Han. Oh, what a reversal into the roll up. 2. No, just a 1 count. Nice armbar there by Yuna. Han. Butterfly, Tiger Driver, 2. She got no, just a 2. Yuna with the Samoan drop. Yuna now for the top rope, waiting on Han. Into a Hurricane Rana with the cover. 2. No.
Yeah.
Nice float over. Oh, into the dragon sleeper. With the grapevine.
Give up.
But Han gets out of it. Nice elbow there by Yuna. Yuna now from the ropes. Oh, what a Hurricane Runner with the roll up. 2. No, just a 2 count. Han now with the forearm. Oh, nice drop toe into the knee bar.
Give up.
Han's trying to get to the ropes, but doesn't get it, but she gets out of it. Now we got to hear a good old-fashioned tug of war. Or should I say a pushing match? Oh, what a neck breaker by Yuna. Now another abdominal. Oh, what a slam there by Yuna. Yuna now off the ropes. Another Hurricane Runner with the cover. Two. No. Nice takedown by Han. Yuna now. Pump handle slam. Almost a modification of the Blue Thunder Bomb. Yuna now. Another Hurricane Runner with the cover.
One, two,
no! Just two and a, two and seven eighths. Nice kick there by Yuna. Yuna now one more time. Hits it. Are we seeing a new champion too? She got it! She got it! That's two! We got a new women's champion! Yuna takes the title! That's two for two for the Gold Wings! Kim Payne making a clean sweep! Our main event is up next! Alright, ladies and gentlemen, this is it. It's the main event for SEA Revenges 2021, and this one is personal. As Payne tries to recapture the championship she never lost, the Queen of Roses championship from the current champion, Shadow Dar. Here comes the challenger. So far tonight, we've had four title matches, and all four has resulted in new champions. Can Payne make it a clean sweep and gain the championship she's never lost, from the woman that took it to the Yami no Kamishu? And here comes the champion, who has to be hot. Not high momentum shy, but pissed after not catching the All-Stars Women's Championship on Rebellion on the Go Home Show last episode. So she now has to focus here tonight against Payne and her title defense for the Queen of Roses Championship. As y'all remember, Payne was the champion, but she had to relinquish the championship due to injury, which unfortunately is now fallen under enemy contact in the Yami no Kamishu. Now, since the Gold Wings won the Queen of Fighters tournament, she now has the chance to get back the championship she's never lost. Neko-chan, I envy you for being the referee for this contest. Because, ladies and gentlemen, this is your main event of SEA Revenges 2021. Is a Queen of Roses championship match as Payne challenges Shadow Dar for the title. As I stated before, Payne is looking for the championship she never lost. And she's got to take it from the woman that has been holding on to it rock heavy. Oh, what a Hurricane Rana there by Payne and Rhea on Grapevine. Now it looks like it got into a chokehold, folds her over, and takes her down. Nice reversal by Shadow Dar. Shadow Dar now with a forearm. Another test of strength. Nice knee there by Payne. Now to into a camel clutch. But Shadow Dar gets out of it. Dar now with the right hand. Nice float over into the back elbow by Shadow Dar into the foot. I mean the boot. Nice blocking by Young Shadow Dar. And a forearm. Nice takedown there by takedown, nice reversal. Nice roll up by Payne. But not even a one count. Shadow Dar throws her in the ropes. No, nothing. Lariat throws Payne to the ropes, but didn't get nothing. Payne now with the judo throw. Nice reversal by Shadow Dar into the drop kick. Nice forearm there by Shadow Dar. Puts her in the, shoots the half into the cover, but not even a one count. Shadow Dar pump handle, nope. Payne off the ropes, into a big boot. And gives her a little neck crank of her own. Nice elbow there by him. And gives her a shot to the gut. Nice block by Shadow Dar under the elbow. Oh, what a neck breaker by Payne. Payne now into the arm triangle. Payne, Shadow Dar now. Ooh, into a big boot of her own and stomps the gut. Nice arm wrench by Payne. And but Shadow Dar throws her to the outside. Neckle chant and minutes is the count. Again throws Payne to the outside.
One, two, three, four.
Oh, what a crossbody by Shadow Dar.
Six.
Nice snap there into a sleeper hold. Nice hurricane runner. Oh, chaos theory. Two? No, just a two count. Nice strikes there. Ooh, into an elbow. Make it two. Side headlock, really wrenching that in. Now to a guillotine. Oh, what a close line by Payne. Off the ropes, into another one. Now again with the arm triangle.
Give up.
Dar gets out of it. More test of strength. Payne now shoots over. Oh, nice roll up. Choke slam. Got it. Cover. Two. No. Went for the pump handle again. And into the Brody Lee Memorial Discus Lariat. Now, and another one. Make it three. Payne now with a clothesline. Again with that submission hold.
Give up.
Payne, tombstone, tombstone! With the cover.
Two.
No, just 2.9. Nice head by Dar. Oh, and another Brody Lee Memorial Discus Lariat. Another one by Payne. Try to go for another one, but didn't get it. And now she's getting uppercuts by Shadow Dar. Shadow Dar. Another test of strength. Both women in stalemate. Oh, what a move there by Payne. And now to a stretch muffler. Nice roll up by Dar. Just a one count. And another Brody Lee Memorial Discus Lariat. Payne is letting him out like, sending him out like hotcakes. Four. And now a head crank. And now the cover. Two? No. Throws Payne in the ropes, but didn't get nothing but a shoulder tackle from Payne. Payne now, arm triumph dragon sleeper. But Dower gets out of it. Just a hammering blows there from Payne. Payne now, another lariat. And again, that submission hold. She's been wearing down Shuttle Dart with that move, both on the arm and the neck. Oh, now a guillotine choke, standing. Oof, what a combination there by a, and another Brody Lee Memorial Discus Lariat. Oh, Argentine Burning Hammer! Payne now, another Lariat. Again with the submission hold. She has that one tight end. Can Shadow Dar hang on to it? She got out of it. Kicks the knee. Oh, another lariat. Oof. She's running out of fumes. She ran out of gas on that one. And another discus lariat. Good God. Brody Lee's got to be proud on these discus lariats. Tombstone, tombstone, tombstone! Cover!
One,
two? No. Nice reversal by Shadow Dawn to the head scissors. Now she gets a cover.
One.
Just a one count. Take down there by Yuna. I mean Payne, my bad. And another lariat by Payne. And went for another one, but didn't get it. But gives her a Pele instead. And both ladies are down. Nice kick there by Shadow Dar. And Payne shoves her down. Choke slam? Yes, it is. Cover.
One,
two?
Two?
No. Oof, oof. Nice strikes there by Shadow Dar. Oh, what a shoulder breaker there by Payne. Dar takes her down. Throws Payne to the ropes. Ooh, gives her a front kick. But gets a boot of her own. Payne now. Ooh, miss on that one. Ooh, nice kick there by Shadow Dar. And I think she just kicked out a tooth. Shadow Dar, ooh, what a baseball slide. But she gets a lariat for her troubles. And another one. One more time with that submission hold.
Give up. Give up. Give up.
Shadowthor gets out of it this time. Covered by Yan Pain. Two. No. Shadowthor really defiant. What a back suplex. She nips up into a super kick. Nice chop there by Shadowthor. Dar's getting that second win. Headbutt. And now up, now jabs. Obey eats an elbow by Yan Pain. Oh, another missed on the pump handle. Again with the reward. And now a standing crab. And she got her foot on Shadowthor's head. Oh, one more time with the burning hammer. And a drop kick to the back of the head. One more time with the tombstone. Got it. Now to cover. Do we see a new champion? Two. No. Nice wicket. Nice clothesline by Payne. And another one. And again with the submission hold. Can Dar get out of it? No, she can't. No, she can't. We got a new champion. She tapped. Payne has done it. Payne has regained the Queen of Roses championship, but she ain't letting go. She is the new champion. It's a clean sweep. We gotta go. We'll see you next time.